invaded by the Germans in 1940, and all transport on Jersey was requisitioned by the German army. So it's sort of, it was King George V, and it was the German army had it, and then it stayed on Jersey until the late 1960s in service. And it's been back here ever since. It's a private bus. We're doing trips on behalf of the museum. It's on loan to the museum. You've all got tickets.
I'll take it.
It's a free ride on it, obviously. If once you've had a trip round, you've enjoyed the ride. If you'd like to make a small donation towards the running costs, that would be gratefully received. Don't worry, if you haven't enjoyed it, it's fine. Just stay on and go around again until you do enjoy it.
I like it.
Anyway, so we'll just take a quick trip around Leyland, give you an idea of what it's like to ride on it. These were the first purpose-designed coaches. This is the first one designed after the First World War. Before that, they were generally just a lorry chassis with a body put on top. This was actually designed as a front-drive coach, you know, like a car more than a bus. And the driver's manual instructs the driver not to exceed 55 miles an hour, which, when you consider the land speed record in 1927, I think it was about 112 miles an hour. 55 was getting off, going by a lot faster than lost in sevens in there anyway. But we're not going to try and find out. don't worry. Okay?
Alright.
Michael will be our conductor today. So any questions about Leyland, please? No, it's people weigh a lot more these days than they used to.
Too nice.
And I've worked it out. If people when the bus was built, weighed an average of 10 stone, let's say. Yeah. And people now weigh 13 or 14 stone. If you fill it up, you've got an extra ton of weight on board.
Yeah, you wouldn't think
you would. You know, people are a lot heavier than they used to be.
Thank you.
it likes to speed up, such a thing we don't want.
This is part of the factory that used to make Centurion tanks. This road called Centurion Way, it's a four-lane highway built to get tanks up and down it. The building you see on your right-hand side was built for the headquarters when it became British Leyland, the British Leyland Water Corporation.
Give up your vows. Give up your...